Hello friends, this video is for BCom semester 4 students and our subject is auditing 1 and topic is vouching. These all are the outlines which we are learned today. First is definition of vouching, second meaning of vouching, list of vouchers, types of vouchers, characteristics of vouching, objects of vouching, importance of vouching, points to be considered in vouching, cash memo, vouchers and auditor's duty. First, definition of vouching. According to B.B. Bose, by vouching is meant the verification of the authority and authenticity of transactions as recorded in the books of accounts. According to Dixie, vouching consists of comparing entries in the books of account which documentary evidence in support therefore. According to Spicer and Pigler, vouching may be defined as the examination by the auditor of all documentary evidence which is available to support the authenticity of transaction entered in the client's record. That means vouching is one kind of documentary evidence which is helpful for the auditor to check and verify all the documents and transactions. Meaning of vouching. Vouching is a process while the documentary evidence used for the purpose of vouching is a voucher. Thus, vouchers are the documentary or other evidence in support of transactions entered in the books of accounts. The following is a list of vouchers used in vouching certain types of transactions. These all are the transactions and the vouchers included in that transactions. The first transaction is cash receipt, and the vouchers included in cash receipts are copy of the receipt issues, counterfoil or receipts, sales or outward invoice, this is also known as a cash memo, contracts, correspondence, minutes and resolutions. The second transaction is cash payment, and the vouchers included in cash payments are receipts issued by the payee, inward or purchase invoice, letters of the collections, contracts, correspondence, resolution, minute book, etc. The third transaction, purchase, and the included vouchers are inward invoices, copy of purchase order, goods received note, correspondence and resolutions. Next one is purchase return. First, copy of debit note issued, credit note received from supplier, goods outward register, correspondence. The next transaction is sales, and the vouchers are copy of outward invoice, copy of order in received, goods outwards register, correspondence and resolutions. And the last transaction, sales return, debit note received, credit note issued to customers, goods received note and correspondence. These two are the bills receivable and bills payable transactions. The bills receivable include bills receivable on hand, entries on receipt side of cash book, bank certificates and bills receivable book. And bills payable include correspondence, entries on payment side of cash book, bank passbook and bills payable book. These all are the list of transactions and included vouchers. Now the next one is types of vouchers. There are total two types of vouchers. The first one is primary vouchers
And the second one is secondary vouchers. Primary vouchers means they are the original evidence of the transactions. That means primary vouchers include original evidence of the transactions and the entries. Second one is secondary vouchers. These vouchers are the copies of the original vouchers left with firms. That means secondary voucher means the copy of the original vouchers or original evidences. The next one is characteristics of vouching. There are total 6 characteristics of vouching. The first one is examination of entries. Second, such examination is done with help of vouchers like receipts, invoices, counterfoil of checkbook, pay-in slip, passbook, agreements, resolution, minute book, correspondence, etc. These all are the vouchers which is help auditors to examination of the entries and transactions during auditing. The third one is such documentary evidence support and substantiate transactions. Four, it ensure the correctness of transaction entered in the books. Next, it is an important aspect of auditing. And the last characteristic of vouching is it is a preliminary work of the auditing. Next, objects of the vouching. There are total 5 objects of the vouching. The first one is to see that all transactions are correctly recorded in the books of account. The first object of the vouching is to see that all the transactions are correctly recorded in the books or not. Second, to see that entries recorded in the books of account are supported by the documentary evidence. That means all the entries which is recorded in the books of account has a proof of the documentary or not. To ascertain that no transaction is left out from being recorded. Four, to ascertain with help of evidence that all transactions are properly authenticated. And last object of the vouching is to see that necessary vouchers relating to entries recorded in the books are with client. Now, next is importance of vouching. There are total 4 importance of vouching. These are reliable examination of original evidences, detection of error at initial stage, and the last one is keeps the auditor alert. Reliable examination. In vouching, the entries in original book of accounts are verified. The entries in the books of accounts are checked to ensure that the transaction is genuine. It is authenticated and it complies with normally accepted principle of accounting. Examination of original evidences. Checking of entries is done by examining the evidence supporting such entries. Vouchers are thus links between transactions and entries. Third, detection of error at initial stage. By checking the entries with original evidence, the errors and frauds can be located at an early stage. Keeps the auditor alert. Since the starting point of audit is vouching, the auditor can detect errors and frauds in the beginning of audit. If he finds any errors, he becomes more alert and careful and adjusts his checking to very important transactions. These all are the importance of vouching. Now, we are going to learn points to be considered in vouching. There are total 13 points of vouching. First, serial number, date, name, address, amount, particular, approval and signature, revenue stamp, continuous vouching, cancelling the voucher, period, entry in the books of account, and list of missing vouchers.
These all are the points which is included in vouching during the auditing. Serial number. The auditor should see that the voucher are consequently numbered according to date and the order of transaction. Second, date. The auditor should carefully check the date on vouchers. Third, name. The voucher should be in the name of client. Four, address. The voucher should be addressed to the client in whole books the transaction is recorded. Fifth, amount. The amount shown in the voucher should tally with the amount recorded in the books of accounts.
Particular. The auditor should carefully examine the particulars mentioned in the voucher. Seventh, approval and signature. Each voucher should be properly approved and authenticated. The person who authorizes payment or other transaction should put his signature in support of having approved the voucher. Revenue stamp. For payments exceeding Rs. 500, the relative receipt should bear revenue stamp of Rs. 1. Continuous vouching. As far as possible, the auditor should complete the vouching of the particular period of book in single sitting. Cancelling the voucher. Once the voucher is audited, the same voucher be cancelled so that it may not be proceed again. Period. The auditor should pay particular attention in the period to which the voucher related. The 12th one is entry in the books of accounts. While examining vouchers, the auditor should see that correct entry in the passes in the books of accounts, and he should see that there is no voucher which is left to be recorded in the books of account. List of missing vouchers. After vouching is over, the auditor should go through the relevant books or register and find out the unticked items. The auditor should prepare a list of missing vouchers and ask the person concerned to obtain the same. These all are the points to be considered in the vouching. Now, this is a cash memo. We can also call it is a voucher. This is a one kind of voucher. You can see that the left side number of voucher, then particular name of the voucher, then particular size, rate, amount, etc. This is an example of voucher. Now, the last topic for vouching is vouching and auditor's duties. The vouching being an important part of auditing. It calls for special care and skill on the part of an auditor. While carrying out the vouching, the auditor should go through the documentary evidence and verify that the transactions are duly approved and are correctly recorded in the books of accounts. The duty of the auditor is to check and verify all the transactions which is recorded in the account books that is correct or not. And the voucher is very useful for the auditor to check all the entries. This examination helps him to give his opinion whether or not the profit and loss account and the balance sheet give a true and fair value of the state of affair of the business. These all evidence are useful for the auditor to give the opinion that he has already checked the profit and loss and balance sheet, which is giving the true and fair value or not. The success of vouching depends on the skill, intelligence, experience, and common sense of the auditor. Of course, the successful vouching and the successful auditing is depends on the skills, intelligence, experience, and common sense of the auditor. The auditor should see that no entry or transaction is left unchecked for want of vouchers. Vouching requires exercise of care and skill, even in respect of the transaction of small value. Even there is a small business and small transactions during the year and small values of the amounts, there also they need vouching for the auditing. The experience vouching includes checking of posting, calculation, totals and balance of the ledger accounts. Thus, it should be remembered that in vouching payments, auditor has not simply to see that the payments have been made and the payments are supported by evidence. He will have also to verify that they are properly authorized and correctly recorded. The duty of the auditor is not to check the payments which is made or not, but they also have to verify all the transactions which is authorized or correctly recorded in the book or not. The entries for payments recorded on credit side of cash book should further be checked in following respects. These all are the points of credit side of the cash book. First, that the payment is made to the proper party, the receipt or cash memo should be obtained from the party. Second, that the payment is made for the purpose of business. Third, that it is correctly recorded in books and not left out. Fourth, that is properly approved by competent official. And the last one is that the payment is not made fraudulently. Here our vouching is complete. Thank you so much.